The FlowServe PSS3 Precision Split Seal combines innovative design with enhanced pressure capability. Optimized face loading maintains seal contact even during fluctuating pressure conditions. And externally mounted springs and pins eliminate clogging and corrosion concerns. Bottom line, the PSS3 is ideal for light chemical and general industrial applications, and when properly installed, will provide reliable process containment over a long service life. The PSS3 is easy to install. Its unitized component, semi-cartridge design, installs around the shaft outside the seal chamber, with the pump or mixer fully assembled. No setting dimensions or measurements are required when installing the seal. This video provides an overview of the PSS3 installation. Prior to beginning, it is important to read the installation manual in its entirety and to ensure that all applicable safety and equipment lockout procedures are complied with. To get started, remove the seal components and installation materials from the box. Lay them out on a clean, flat surface. Make sure you have two seal drive assembly halves and two gland assembly halves. Note that depending on the seal size and the pump configuration, the gland assembly halves may be castings or machined from bar stock. You should also have an assortment of hex key wrenches, lubricant, and spare fasteners. As for tools, you'll only need to provide an open-ended wrench, a common flathead screwdriver, and a torque wrench. To install the seal drive, first lubricate all the exposed surfaces of the sleeve gasket, rotating face gasket ends, and seal drive split joint gaskets with the enclosed lubricant. Next, confirm that the set screws are backed out of the seal drive bore, so they do not interfere with the fit of the seal drive around the shaft. Loosely assemble the seal drive halves around the shaft by finger tightening the drive cap screws. Slide the seal drive towards the seal chamber until all the setting devices contact the face of the seal chamber. With the seal drive still loose, align the rotating faces at their OD and at the sealing surface interface, so there is no step at the joints. Tighten the seal drive cap screws firmly and recheck the rotating face joints for alignment. You'll find the torque recommendations for your specific seal in the seal installation and operation manual. A small mismatch between the rotating faces can be corrected by pushing on the high side of the joint or gently prying on the low side. The rotating face joints must be flat and smooth on both the sealing face and the OD of the ring. Any mismatch will result in leakage. If a mismatch exists, loosen the seal drive cap screws 1 to 2 turns. Realign the rotating faces and retighten the cap screws. Now, clean the rotating face with alcohol. With the setting devices against the face of the seal chamber, tighten the seal drive set screws. Tighten all the set screws on one split joint before moving on and tightening the set screws on the other split joint. The necessary torque will vary by seal size. Refer to the installation instructions provided with the seal for the correct torque values. Tighten the set screws a second time in the same order, and then recheck the seal face for joint alignment. Finally, re-clean the seal faces and remove the setting devices by unscrewing the socket head cap screw from the seal drive. This completes the installation of the rotating portion of the seal. To install the seal gland, you may need to temporarily remove the gland studs to allow the gland halves to fit around the shaft. Next, lubricate the split face ends of the stationary seal face with the lubricant provided. Then, lubricate the gasket ends and the exposed surfaces of the split joint gaskets. Clean the stationary seal faces with alcohol. Next, carefully assemble the gland halves around the rotor. Avoid any contact between the seal face and the shaft. Finger tighten the gland cap screws, leaving a gap between the gland halves about 8/10 of a millimeter or 30/1000 of an inch wide. If previously removed, reinstall the gland studs at this point. Now, finger tighten the gland mounting nuts so the gland is supported at the pump mounting surface. Firmly press the gland up against the seal drive and towards the seal chamber, while fully tightening the gland cap screws. Again, refer to the installation instructions provided with the seal for the proper torque settings. This action will align the stator faces with the rotor faces, thereby assuring there is no step in the stator face joints. Next, tighten the gland mounting nuts evenly until the gland gasket is fully compressed and the gland is squarely seated against the face of the seal chamber. Observe the length of the lock pins outside of the gland. They should extend 2.5 to 4.8 millimeters or 100 to 190 thousandths of an inch from the gland. If outside these parameters, remove the gland and recheck the installation. To complete the seal installation, pry off the centering devices with a screwdriver. If required, connect the flush line to the gland or plug if unused. Turn the shaft by hand as a final check to be sure nothing is binding the rotating seal face. Before startup, vent air from the seal chamber and follow all applicable safety and equipment startup procedures. FlowServe offers repair kits as well as individual parts to restore a worn PSS3 split seal to original performance. These kits and parts are available from numerous FlowServe Quick Response Center stocking locations for immediate response to customer needs. For more information about FlowServe seals, please visit flowserve.com or contact your local FlowServe representative.